folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on generating pre-signed MinIO URLs with .NET. And in this video, we're going to be using .NET version 6, and we're going to be connecting to play.min.io, our online sandbox for anyone who wants to work with the MinIO platform. And all of our code is going to be run out of Visual Studio 2022 for Mac. And we're going to be talking about a couple of different things here. First off, we're going to talk about the pre-signed getObjectAsync method and its associated arguments. And one of those arguments is an expiry time for the URL that gets generated. We're going to show you how you can actually set that so that a URL that you hand to somebody will not be just good forever. It will have a specific time during which it's valid, after which you won't be able to use it any longer. So let's take a look at our code. I've got a very simple main method here. The main method is just going to connect out to play.min.io. It's going to set up a bucket and an object for me to download, and then it's going to handle all of my exceptions for me while I call this run method. Now, in the run method, I have bucket name and object name. The bucket is .NET demo bucket. My object is hello world text. And what I'm going to do is I want to get a pre-signed URL so that I can download this object from this bucket. To do this, I am going to call the pre-signed getObjectAsync method. And in order to do that, I need to have the args object. The pre-signed getObjectArgs object takes a bucket and an object and an expiry time. Now, if I don't give it an expiry time, the expiry time defaults to 7 days. But as you can see here, I've set it up to actually be 1 day. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to dial that back just a little bit. I'm going to make it a 60-second expiry time so that you can see that it's going to work for a little while and then it's going to quit. So let's go ahead and open up our terminal and we will run this. So first let's try to actually download the object without using a pre-signed URL. So if I do a curl https play.min.io and I hand it .NET demo bucket and I hand it hello world, I'm going to get an access denied. Now I need a pre-signed URL because I don't want to open up the bucket to everybody in the world with a public bucket. And I could also hand somebody credentials, but then I'd have to manage all those credentials. Just for this one object, I'm just going to give them a pre-signed URL that'll be good for 60 seconds or so. And then once that's over with, they're not going to be able to hit it up anymore. So let's go ahead and run this with .NET run. And I'm going to output this to a file called URL text. And the reason for that is the URL is pretty complicated. It's a little difficult to copy paste here in the terminal. But let me show you what's in there. If I do a cat on URL text, you can see that I get some AMZ expires, some signed headers, all that other fun stuff to show that I'm using a URL that is pre-signed that I can use to download this particular file. So let me go do a clear, and now I'm going to do a curl, and I'm going to backtick this cat URL text so that the URL text gets echoed into curl for me. And when I run this, there we go. I get my Bob Ross output from helloworld.txt. I can run this a few times and I will keep getting results back, but after 60 seconds, you are going to get a fail. And what that fail is going to look like is something like this. If I run this one more time, now I'm going to get a failure. And there it is. The request has expired. So that's everything I want to show you on the pre-signed getObjectAsync. I hope you enjoyed this little video. If you'd like to connect with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can interact with us directly on minio.slack.com, or you can always just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.